Blue, green, teal?
What's up, guys? I'm Random Frank P, back with episode 173 of Room Tour Project, the series where we show off some of the best gaming setups to give you some ideas, inspirations for your own setup. And this week we'll have a special single monitor only edition, switching it up as we always do. If you see anything you like, I'll have it all listed for you in the description down below so you can check it out. Let's start it off, episode 173. First, we have Locke, and this is an obvious God of War theme. Well, it might not be obvious yet, but you'll see. This is all about God of War, from the wallpaper, the custom PC, down to a ton of figures around the room, all completing a really nice setup in front of that massive window. Loving the natural lighting. So checking it out, he's going with a 34-inch Asus ROG monitor, the nice 34-inch ultra-wide there. And as you're seeing with pretty much every new photo, the color of the PC and the wallpaper are changing, but still matching all God of War theme. For his peripherals, he has the Asus ROG Claymore keyboard with the ROG Puggio mouse. I've never heard of that, probably pronounced it wrong. And then for audio, he has, you guessed it, the ROG Strix Fusion 700 headset and a white pair of Dyne Audio speakers. Got them on each side of the monitor, and this is where you're gonna start to see, you know, more of the figures. And I just love stuff like this around the room to make it more personal than on those shelves, not just God of War stuff, but Batman, Witcher, other superhero and gaming figures. But switching gears back to his PC, inside he has an Intel i9-7900X CPU on the Asus Rampage 11 Extreme motherboard, 64 gigs of G-Skill Triton Z RGB RAM, and an Asus RTX 2080 Ti with a custom water block there, as you can see with the God of War design. Even the CPU block is the custom made with the Omega symbol. Really unique and a cool looking build for sure. So starting off strong here, again, I love a themed setup like this. Always looks really, really nice. Also keeping it pretty nice and simple with the single display and a nice and organized desk setup. Next is Morpho, and this one is really cool in the sense that this is a completely custom made desk. People all the time are like, oh Frank, why don't you put the desk down below? Because 9 times out of 10, it's a custom desk that they make. This is a really cool one with like the custom resin river running through it with the wood on each side. And absolutely great end results. I just love seeing stuff like this. And DIY desks definitely help make the whole setup itself more personal in the end. Now, checking it out, his single display is the Dell 21.5-inch monitor. RGB lights behind the desk and behind the monitor itself, as you can see, to throw some extra, you know, color on the wall. Then down to his peripherals, loving this shot. Got the Corsair K65 Lux RGB keyboard with the Logitech G603 wireless mouse. And for audio, although not pictured, he's using the Logitech Z207 speaker setup. Now over to the PC, and no, it's not floating, which it did look like, depending on the angle you see this on. This is also sitting on like an acrylics box or a stand, which does kind of give it that floating appearance. But inside, the NZXT S340 Elite case is an AMD Ryzen 2700 CPU with the NZXT Kraken X62 AIO on the MSI B450 Tomahawk motherboard with 16 gigs of Team Vulcan RAM with an Asus Strix GTX 1070 Ti graphics card, and of course the NZXT Hue Plus for that RGB lighting. So a pretty chill setup as a whole, but again, the desk is stealing the show here with the wooden resin river. Loving the end result, looks so great, and it's not an IKEA desk like 99% of us have, so big ups for that. Now we have Chris, and so far this could have been, you know, a clean and minimal setup addition, because this one fits right in the all white sterile kind of setup, no clutter going on, making that single monitor stand out even more. So that is the Asus ROG Swift 27-inch 165Hz monitor. Got it propped up on some sort of riser here. And getting into his gear, you can see hanging on his PC case, he has the Sennheiser Game 1 headset with the Audio Engine A2 Plus speakers. And then the Mastrop Alt keyboard with the Logitech G Pro wireless mouse with the Logitech G640 mouse pad. So pretty good peripherals. And you take a look at this Mastrop Alt, looks like a render, it looks so clean. Inside, he has the 67-gram Zilio switches with the SA Hyperfuse keycap set, making this thing look pretty damn nice. Checking out the PC, yet again, we have the S340 Elite case from NZXT. Inside here is an Intel i7-8700K CPU with the NZXT Kraken X62 AIO with 16 gigs of G-Scale Trident Z RGB RAM on an Asus Maximus 10 Hero motherboard and an Asus Strix GTX 1080 Ti graphics card. Some custom braided cables always goes a long way, and having those inside here definitely helps fit it to his black and white setup. Super clean stuff from Chris, gotta love it. I like the addition of hanging the headset on the S340 Elite case with their puck, clear up some space there, go with the wireless mouse and a really nice custom keyboard to bring this thing together. Now we've got Gary, and Gary likes himself some Razer. Let's put it that way, because everything here is Razer. Everything. And it's a pretty nice setup, going with the, you know, the IKEA Alex drawers and the black desktop. Definitely accentuating that green color with the black and green makes it pop even more. So let's start checking it out. This is the Samsung 32-inch 2K curved gaming monitor. And yes, you know, when Razer releases their Raptor monitor, this is gonna be replaced. And sitting up top there, he's even got the Razer Caillou webcam, those crazy Razer Nomo Pro speakers. I reviewed them last year and they're crazy. They've got some power to them. And for the rest of his peripherals, we got the Razer Huntsman Elite keyboard with the Razer Mamba Tournament Edition mouse sitting on the Razer Goliathix extended Chroma mouse pad, the Razer Nari headset, which is then sitting on the Razer Chroma base station headset stand. Not pictured, but it's there somewhere. Now down to the PC. This is the Leon Lee 011 Dynamic Razer Edition case, of course, with the i7-8700K CPU, the Asus Z370F gaming motherboard with 32 gigs of G-Scale Trident Z RGB RAM, and an Asus Strix GTX 1080 Ti graphics card. But again, looks super nice. The hard tubing here, nice and clear. Wow. So Gary, your loyalty does not go unnoticed. I wouldn't be surprised if you got some ink on you. I have seen someone with a Razer tattoo before, so it wouldn't be too crazy. But what is crazy is how nice this setup is. For everything you got going on, it still looks pretty well organized and it has a nice flow to it. And then last but not least is Tech Tagged. And yes, this still counts as a single monitor setup because that is his setup in the closet. I always enjoy seeing closet setups because it really gives them limited space to work with. And 9 times out of 10, that's when you see their creativity maximized and they have just the best setup possible working with what they have. We'll talk about those other displays in a minute. His single monitor is the Dell 27-inch 144Hz 1440p monitor. There, for everybody who got on me last week for messing that one up. Of course, up on the wall to make that closet glow, you have the Nanoleaf Aurora light panels. Then as for the peripherals, you got the Razer Huntsman Elite keyboard with the SteelSeries Rival 650 mouse on the SteelSeries Quick Prism extra large extended mouse pad. For audio, the Razer Noma Chroma speakers were tucked behind the monitor. Got the SteelSeries Arctis 7 wireless headset sitting on the Razer Chroma base station there. Then over to the PC. This is a pre-built from iBuyPower, so not too sure of the exact case, but inside is an Intel i7-8700K CPU with 16 gigs of RAM and an MSI RTX 2080. That's about all the info we have on that. Can't get a good look at the actual RAM or the motherboard or what that cooler is, but that's all right. But now bringing it outside of the closet back to his entertainment setup, those are two 50-inch 4K TV side by side. Why that is necessary or why that's needed, I really don't know. Unless like one's for you, one your significant other, or you just want one TV for two different things, one for a roommate maybe. Whatever it is, you got two massive TVs side by side. But that doesn't take away from the really awesome closet setup you have going on. Again, with limited space, maximum potential, made it look really good. And this episode of Room Tour Project is brought to you by Corsair and the Harpoon Wireless RGB mouse. Coming in at just $50, this revolutionary wireless mouse is top of the line in terms of reliability and practically zero latency, all thanks to Slipstream. With a 60-hour battery life, an ergonomic design, 6 programmable buttons, and RGB lights, you really can't beat it for that $50 price. If you want to check it out, I'll put a link for you in the description down below. All right, guys, that'll wrap it up for episode 173 of Room Tour Project. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget, check the links in the description down below for all the gear and hardware you saw. Have listed down there for you, as well as some very simple instructions on how to submit your setup if you want to be possibly considered being a future episode of Room Tour Project. Check the description down below for it all. you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up to show your support. Feel free to follow me on Twitter, @randomfrankp. And last, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I hope you enjoyed. Have a good day.